In 2013, we got an extension. In fact, then 8 centers were selected worldwide, and we were one of them. So these 8 centers are from Pakistan, India, Portugal, Bolivia, Brazil, Singapore, Hong Kong, Australia. 2015, later on, they changed the policy. Now they are trying to find out or figure out a center of excellence of diabetes education in each country, which I'm sure you might have been contacted in this regard. Next is diabetic foot, which is our priority. We have established 115 diabetic foot clinics all over Pakistan. We initially set up our own tertiary care diabetic foot clinic from 96 to 2006. We were able to demonstrate that we reduced our amputation rate by 75%. Then we embarked on a national diabetic foot program, and we trained diabetic foot teams all over Pakistan. And when we say diabetic foot teams, we do training of the doctor as well as his paramedic, who is like his podiatrist, you can call. Podiatry, you know, is very expensive to be able to organize in developing world. So we train our own foot care assistants. These are called diabetes foot care assistants. They are not podiatrists, they are not surgeons, but they are having 6 weeks course in diabetic foot surgeries, minor surgeries, and dressings, etc. And hence we have trained 115 such foot teams, and we have reduced the amputation rate by half in these 115 foot clinics. This also got international recognition. So in 2007, 2011, 2015, every 4 years, an international diabetic foot conference is held by International Working Group on Diabetic Foot in Holland, Netherlands. And I am part of those guidelines which are developed every 4 years. And you can imagine that it's important to have people from the developing world in developing these guidelines, which are international document. Not all the fancy things coming from the Western world, like specialized dressings, specialized foot casts and footwears, can be afforded by a majority of the developing world. So people like me who are there sitting in the board developing the guidelines do have a say when we talk of requirements as per the resource-constrained societies. The next of such meeting is in May 2019 in The Hague, Netherlands, and I'm invited as an international scientific advisory board in this regard. We have now developed an advisory board for the care of diabetes in Pakistan, which involves 10 teaching hospitals pan-Pakistan, and we are digitally linking all these 10 institutes. So we can have all those special expert clinics or collaborations needed, which can be now done virtually. The first which we have decided and started is National Diabetic Foot Advisory Board meeting. So every Wednesday, 9 a.m., the whole board is meeting pan-Pakistan virtually through WhatsApp, emails, Skype, Cloud, etc., etc. And we are having a foot clinic. All difficult foot cases of Pakistan seen in these 10 teaching hospitals are being discussed by the Diabetic Foot Board to reduce the amputation pan-Pakistan. I also happen to be chair of the IDF Diabetic Foot MENA group, which involves the whole 22 countries I've described already. The third priority was diabetes and children. We know type 1 diabetes. We were just discussing with a professor from Taiwan, Professor Xu, and he was saying that in type 1 diabetes, if we do not manage early in a best way, we are having high risk of not only micro but macrovascular complications at young ages, because they develop type 1 diabetes at young age. Even if they develop complication in 10, 15 years, they still will be in their youth of 25 and 30. In Pakistan, we were having a problem that majority of our type 1 diabetics coming from the poor or the resource-constrained societies were not able to afford insulin. So we started developing a project with the collaboration of the World Diabetes Foundation. This was in the province of Sindh. 34 role model type 1 diabetes model clinics were established. We sensitized the teachers. We are now giving free insulin to 1,900 plus type 1 diabetes subjects in Sindh. Now in Peshawar, in KPK, we are pleased to say that they are also having free insulin given to their type 1 diabetics, and Punjab has also started. So majority, at least 3/4 of Pakistan, is now giving free insulins to non-affording type 1 diabetics in Pakistan.
Zifam, caring for well-being.